Do you have an invention? Do you know how much research you need to do on it before filing a patent? In this video, I'm going to talk a little bit about this issue. Unfortunately, I can't give a hard and fast answer, but I can give you some information to help you think about it before you go through the expense of patenting. Part of the reason for ambiguity pertaining to how much work should be done on an invention before patent protection is sought relates to what are called predictable and unpredictable arts. For predictable arts, there is a lower burden of proof required for the patent seeker than for the unpredictable arts. Some inventions simply require more work than others. There is no exact dividing line for the amount of work you need to do before filing an application for a patent. Some inventors and companies choose to err on the side of doing more work than may be necessary for filing a patent application, whereas others do relatively less research, thereby filing patents quickly before going through extensive testing and refining of their inventions. Risk is involved no matter which way you choose. Take too much time to do your research, and others will beat you to the patent office. Put in too little effort, and your inventions may not be enabled sufficiently or may not allow many options during prosecution. The more support you have for an invention which you can talk about in a patent, the stronger your patent may be, the more options that will be available for claim amendment to capture what you want. The less support you have for your invention naturally leads to the expectation that the patent may be weaker with fewer choices for amendment. The more work you do on an invention, the more you'll understand its strengths and weaknesses. This helps you plan for future innovation and corresponding patent filings. In contrast, an invention can always be improved, so you'll want to consider filing sometime before every last bit of knowledge that can be gained for the invention is acquired. The longer you wait, especially in a fast-moving arena, the more risk you run that someone else will independently invent the same thing that you want to claim as yours. If they file their application before you, it no longer matters in the US if you can show that you were first to invent. As I said, it is impossible to state exactly how much you should do before submitting your patent application. Yet the basic rule for inventions require that they be more than just good ideas. Ideas may be likened to a conception in your mind. Inventions move beyond that to a practical application in the real world. You must know how to realize a good idea for it to be called an invention. You must be able to teach others who have an average skill in the same technical area of your invention how to practice your invention in your patent application. However, let me make it clear, do not actually teach others about your invention until you get a patent application on file, unless you know the risks to possible future patents you may want on that invention. Of course, you can always consult with a USPTO registered patent practitioner without divulging anything to the public. Otherwise, keep everything secret. Please see some of my other videos for more information on this topic. If you can't make your good idea reality, then your invention is not legitimately an invention, but just an idea. You must think two basic things for an invention: conception and reduction to practice. Conception means you have an idea that is useful. As a hypothetical example, if you think that attaching silicon atoms to the surface of a metal plate will solve a real problem, then you have conceived an idea. You don't know how to accomplish it yet. You need to do some experimentation. So you go to the lab and start learning how to accomplish your idea over the next 3 months, wherein you come to a startling discovery. If you put chemicals X, Y, and Z in solvent S, subsequently dip the metal in that solution, pull it out, and then bake it at 400 degrees Fahrenheit for 2 hours to give a 90% coverage of the metal surface with silicon, then you have moved beyond the good idea. Now you have a practical means for realizing your idea. At this stage, you have an invention because it is reduced to practice. You can make it happen and in principle give people a recipe for how to accomplish it. You could consider filing a patent application at this stage or continue to find a wider range of conditions that fulfill your goal. The choice is yours with consequences either way. I hope this video helps you. If you like this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Please leave your comments below.